So why is Allah saying to him the following ayah? Stay away, ya Muhammad, from idols.
You're supposed to be a follower of Jesus, and you're using words like that.
Well, it's not my words. It's not my words. It's the words of Allah. Are you embarrassed of Allah?
مباشرة كأنه بيبي صغير ما حصلش. ليه ما حصلش يا أخوانا؟ علشان هم جهلة ما بيقروش في الكتب، علشان هم مدلسين. عندنا في الطبقات الكبرى لابن سعد، وكذلك ذكر هذا الأثر في الحافظ ابن حجر في الإصابة في تمييز الصحابة، ذكر أن اللي حصل إيه بقى؟ بيحكي أن الست لما راحت لسيدنا النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام حكت له القصة اللي أنا حكيتها لكم دي كلها، قال لها يا ستي رضيت بإيه زي أمي وتحرمي علي. عملت إيه بقى؟ إزاي تم شربه؟
يجي بقى يحكي لك يقول لك لا، ده يقول لك فكان يوضع له هذا اللبن أو هذا الحليب في شيء ليشربه فشرب ذلك خمس مرات.
Now, modern Muslims of today, like this honorable Sheikh from Al-Azhar, Abdullah Rushdie, whom you just heard talking, and many other Muslim apologists of today, like Sister Farida, or aka Farid Leaks, as we love to call him, try to fix this created disaster of their perverted prophet, who used to command Muslim women in the 7th century to breastfeed adult men with long beards, by going to a famous hadith quoted by people like Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, or short for Ibn Hajar. This is the same Ibn Hajar who wrote Fath al-Bari, which is the multi-volume commentary on the hadith collection of Sahih al-Bukhari. Ibn Hajar is one of the famous scholars who made this hadith famous, which embarrassed Muslims of today love to use to solve this problem. Now let us investigate the supposed hadith that these deceivers used to sugarcoat the issue. Could this very hadith be sahih? Let us see. This is the hadith that they are using. Ibn Sa'd's Tabaqat al-Kubra, as you see here, quoted by Ibn Hajar. An amount of a drink, breast milk, was collected in a pot or glass or a cup, and Salim used to drink it every day for 5 different days. After this, he used to enter upon her, i.e. Sahla bin Suhail, while her head was uncovered. This was permission from the Messenger of Allah to Sahla bin Suhail. What modern Muslims of today, like Sister Farida or Abdullah Rushdie from Al-Azhar, what they don't like to tell you is that the one who narrated this hadith is Al-Waqidi. Who is Al-Waqidi? Now let us ask Sister Farida or Farid Leaks who Al-Waqidi is. And is Al-Waqidi a trustworthy person? Can you trust him as a Muslim? And should you use any of his hadith? Sister Farida, can you tell us what Al-Waqidi is?
The same idea is narrated by Al-Waqidi, who's also another liar.
Wait, I did not hear you.
However, in my opinion, the biggest issue with the hadith is that it's reported by Muhammad bin Umar al-Waqidi.
Who? Fifi who?
With the hadith is that it's reported by Muhammad bin Umar al-Waqidi.
Al-Waqidi, the same Waqidi. Okay, what are you going to say about al-Waqidi, Sister Fifi? Sister Fifi, what about al-Waqidi? What do you want to say about al-Waqidi?
Muhammad bin Umar al-Waqidi is actually a fabricator.
Now, let's say that Sister Farida from Farida Response is a liar, or he does not know what he's talking about. What about the most famous, the most influential scholars or imams in Sunni Islam? What did they say about Al-Waqidi? Famous people who criticized Al-Waqidi are also Al-Shafi'i, Ahmad ibn Hanbal, Al-Nisa'i, Al-Bukhari, Yahya ibn Mu'in, and Abu Dawood. They called him a liar, a deceiver, and all of his hadith and books are rejected. He is not reliable. His hadiths are weak. He is nothing. Al-Waqidi has been abandoned, said Ibn Hajar. So you see, Ibn Hajar turns out to be a munafiq, a hypocrite, who uses hadith of a guy whose hadith is totally rejected. Now here is the question. Why would Ibn Hajar use rejected hadith of a known liar and a fabricator like Al-Waqidi? Well, because Ibn Hajar is another munafiq, a deceiver, a hypocrite. But what can we expect from Muslim scholars? In the end, without their lies, Islam dies. So Ibn Hajar is a deceiver. But still, Muslims put their salvation and their trust in such scholars of Islam. This is really embarrassing, ya Muslimin. Why are you using the so-called hadith of breastfeeding inside a cup while the hadith is rejected, totally rejected, because the narrator of that hadith is a liar, a known fabricator? All of his hadith are rejected. Are you going to be a munafiq, a hypocrite like Ibn Hajar, who made that rejected hadith famous in the Muslim world? Well, it's your janazah, it's your funeral, ya Muslimin. It is your salvation that is on the line. Yet recently, a Muslim like Muhammad Hijab was so disgusted of the idea and started to cause havoc on Twitter. That very day, a big portion of the Ummah drowned on social media. The fallout, the damage afterwards was so huge, it actually forced Mr. Hijab to stop using Twitter. Well, yes, ya Muslimin, the adult breastfeeding, of course, did happen directly from the nipple. And we proved to you that the hadith which embarrassed Muslims like Farid or Abdullah Rushdie used to sugarcoat the disaster turned out to be totally rejected. A da'if hadith, right? Ya Masakin, why is it else called breastfeeding and not simply drinking from a cup? Hello, wake up. Did Muhammad order the woman to pour some of her breast milk inside a cup and let adult men drink from the breast milk from that cup? Of course not. Of course not. He commanded the poor lady to breastfeed the adult men by suckling directly from her nipples on 5 different days. Else, it would not count at all. We can conclude that Muslims of today are simply embarrassed about their fraud, sexually perverted prophet, and need to do tarqiya, basically sugarcoating and fixing this disaster that Muhammad created in the 7th century. By using a rejected hadith by a known fabricator like Al-Waqidi. Ya Muslimin, please wake up.
أنا تربيت بينهم ودرست على أيديهم. أنا إنسان تربيت مساجدهم. كثير الأمور يخفيها رجال الدين كثيرة. موجود عندنا مصايب في كتب الدين والفقه موجودة كثيرة، بس هم ما يحبون يناقشون ولا يحبون نعرضها على الناس. وإذا عرضتها يقول لك فلان يشكك، وإذا عرضتها يقول لك يشكك الناس في الإسلام. لا، أنا ماشي، هذا موجود في كتب الإسلام. لما يجيني حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يطوف على نساء 9 وبغسل واحد وتذكره، لا تشكك، هذا موجود في كتب الإسلام. ليه تخافون من الناس؟ ليه تخافون من الناس؟ ليه؟ فهذا موجود. فعندنا كثير أمور رجال الدين يخفون 90% ويخشون، والله يخافون يطلعون في تساؤلات كثيرة. أنت لو تتعمق بالمصائب التي يخفيها رجال الدين، بس حنا رجال الدين دائما خلاص يخفون الكثير. والله لو خرج رجل دين يتبنى أفكاره وفتواه أن أمة ستنقلب عليهم. لكن كيف أنا أتبنى؟ كيف أنا أنصر منهجي؟ كيف أن أخفي أفكاري وأظهر اللي أنا وأنت يمكن أن نختلف به؟ فإذا سؤالك، 90% يخفون رجال الدين من المعلومات 90% ولا يريدون الناس أن تعلم ولا يريدون الناس أن تعلم ويحرفون الكلام ويكذبون. تصور والله العظيم يكذبون إلا من رحم الله والله يكذبون موجود. فعادي يا أبا سليمان ليه مستغرب أنت؟ تجارة سيدي. كيف هذه الفتوى؟ كيف إرضاع الكبير؟ إرضاع الكبير مثلا يقول لك هي الرضاع مباشرة ما يقدرون كيف وضع فينا وكذا. عندنا أمور لو قلناها لتزندق الناس كفر الناس لهم هم وش عندهم لا بخفيها. يأتي مثلا لمسألة لا يقبلها عقل ولا دين عند فتاوى لا يقبلها مسلم مسلم لا يقبلها مسلم لا يقبلها يأتي يخفيها وأحاديث لا يقبلها عقل يخفيهن. لماذا؟ يقول حتى الناس رحمة بعقول الناس. فالشاهد من الأمر سيدي نعم رجال الدين يخفون مصائب ولو تكلموا بها سينبذهم المجتمع عن بكرة أبيهم.
نعم نعم ما ورد في فتح المنعم في شرح صحيح في شرح صحيح مسلم لموسى شاهين لاشين الجزء الخامس صفحة 222 أنه قال أنه يدخل عليها الغلام الأيسع وكانت عائشة رضي الله عنها ترى أن أرضاع الكبير يحرم وأرضعت غلاما فعلا وكان يدخل عليها. فهل كانت عائشة ترضع شباب قريش؟ هل يجوز ذلك أن تعطيهم الحليب من صدرها؟
Backup channel, please subscribe. Did you subscribe, guys?